Have you ever seen an omnibus go out of print and then go for ridiculously high prices on eBay and ever wondered if it was something that you should consider as an investment? But if you haven't considered all the risks, you need to make sure that you watch this video before you consider doing this. Woof woof! Hey guys, it's me Marcus, aka the Maddogg, and we're back with another video. I know that this topic's probably going to be a controversial one, and people are probably going to dislike this video already just because of the fact that I'm talking about it. But I can't tell you how many times throughout the week I get people asking me on either a video or directly on Instagram if a book's worth picking up solely because of the fact that they want to sell it on later for a greater price if it becomes out of print. You may not like the fact that people scalp books, but it is unfortunately just part of the hobby now, so I thought it was best to give my two cents on it. And if you don't want to watch the full video and my reasonings behind it, my answer would be no, it's not really worth doing this if you don't know what you're doing. And I'm not any kind of financial advisor. If anything, I'm broke because of this channel anyway, so clearly probably don't get any kind of money advice off me. It's a practice that many people don't agree with. I don't think it's viable either, but there is a slim chance that you might be able to get some good money from it, so I thought I'd sit down and list it with you in case it's something that you're interested in. So the first negative that you need to consider before doing this is the storage and the length of time that you might have to hold on to a book. Omnibuses aren't small, they're known for being thick, and especially if you're getting absolutes or maybe any other kind of big book as well, you're going to have to store that in a way that it's not going to inflict damage on the book. So realistically, you might not be able to do this with a lot of books at once, and you've also got to consider that at the time when you buy that book, it's very unlikely that it's already out of print in a whale. Say for example you just bought something like the Moon Knight Omnibus, which only recently came out, because maybe you could get it for about 40% off, which is really good, and especially if you're planning to sell it for over cover price once it goes out of print, there is going to be a very decent return there. However, what if this book doesn't go out of print for about 3 or 4 years? Obviously, I know that currently omnibuses are going out of print a lot quicker than that, and sometimes they go out of print at the point where they're even being sold, but I don't feel like that'll last forever, and eventually companies like Marvel and DC will get ahead of themselves and omnibuses will be in stock for a lot longer. So are you going to be able to adequately store these books for as long as it takes for them to go out of print and you to be able to turn the profit that you want? First up on the positives is that it's easier to know this market if you're already a fan of it. As this is a niche and it's not something that the mainstream really knows about, like something like gold or maybe the housing market, you can end up buying stuff because you know exactly what behavior is going to dictate whether that's going to go out of print or maybe even get a reprint. I remember when I was at uni and I didn't make too much money, I was tempted to buy quite a few of the Infinity Gauntlet omnibuses because it originally came out at a time when Thanos wasn't really known as the big bad within the MCU and there wasn't too many people that were aware of what the Infinity Gauntlet was. I didn't end up buying it, but I did end up keeping track of it, and of course it did go out of print, and around about the time when the first Avengers Infinity War trailer came out, everybody started selling their Infinity War omnibuses. I know that some of these were going for stupid prices, even over £200, at which case if you bought that for about the £60 that it was readily available in stock for, you were probably going to get at least over 3 times your money on it. So because those people were savvy with the market and they knew exactly what time was best to sell that book, they didn't end up getting into a situation where it's now and a reprint has been announced, so the value that they got at the time when they sold it when the trailer for Avengers Infinity War came out has now been lost. But the second negative that you need to consider ties directly into the last point, that reprints are frequent and it could decimate any kind of profit that you were hoping to make. You might be one of those people that you don't know when to abandon the ship, and in this case you don't know when to sell a book. Although it's not an omnibus, let's use the example of Usagi Yojimbo Volume 1. Let's say you had one of these and you've been sitting on it for years just because of the fact that you knew it was so limited in numbers and you knew that more people needed Volume 1 than the rest of the other volumes that had come out. Well, it might be the case that you waited a little bit too long because you didn't know when exactly to jump ship. And the book that nobody thought was going to get a reprint now got a reprint, so the value of your book has now just been slashed. So you might have been sitting on a book for years and now you don't even know if you can get the same value that you paid for it. But the second positive on the list does sound like it's a bit contradictory to the last one that I just made, but if you buy an omnibus as an investment, you're very unlikely to lose all of your money. Now if you're into your stocks, or maybe you buy metals, or maybe you invest in the housing market, it could be the case that you end up losing all the money that you put into it. And even though those examples probably hold much more money in them, with an omnibus you're probably bare minimum going to get just about the amount that you paid for originally. Because think about it, if just a standard reprint comes out, people will still probably want the book that you've got. It's just the case that you won't have that same profit that you were hoping for in the beginning, but it's not the case that you're now going to be left with something that holds no value or that you're just going to have to throw it away. However, the one exception to this rule is also the third negative on this list, because it's the recent release of all these expanded editions of omnibuses that have been coming out. So we're looking at stuff like the Super Sons expanded edition, the re-release of the new Teen Titans with the better mapping, and and the recent release of the Eternals Omnibus. Now, using that last example, the original Eternals Omnibus was a whale for the longest amount of time, but it was a very thin book. I wasn't really tracking this one, so I don't really know how much people were selling it for in the aftermarket and after it'd gone out of print and stuff like that, but once that re-release came out, and it was like about 4 times bigger than the original book, and it also had stories that the original didn't contain, anybody that had that original book and was waiting until the movie came out to sell it has now probably made a huge loss on that. Nobody's going to want this inferior edition, and another example is the recent Super Sons Omnibus. If you bought that original release and you were hoping to sit on it for quite a few years and then eventually turn a profit, unfortunately those plans have been derailed for you by DC. But that's one of the risks that you're going to have to take into consideration. And as well, let's say you bought a book that's got really famously poor binding, something like the Ultimate Spider-Man Miles Morales Omnibus. That got a reprint that fixed the bad binding, so anybody that had that original printing, now people are going to be in doubt if they're going to buy it off you, if that book's even going to be worth buying. So again, there's so much that you have to know about this. You have to understand the condition, the sort of history of that book, and if it's something that might end up getting corrected in a later release. Before we jump into the rest of the list, I'd just like to remind you that if you're enjoying this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you don't like this video, you've probably already disliked it anyway because of the fact that somebody's talking about a topic that you don't agree with. If you're new here, please make sure that you get your paws all over that subscribe button and click the bell notification so that you never miss a video. I've also got my social media links up there, and I've got my Twitter handle down below, and we've also got our own Reddit page, r/MaddoggComicCommunity. I've got Amazon affiliate links down below if you do want to support the channel. It is greatly appreciated. And as well, another way that you can support the channel, because I am trying to get off the ground properly with this now, is that you can just share this in any groups on your Twitter, your Reddit, your Instagram, or anything like that. Share it with your parents, who keep asking you why you're not a millionaire already, which has brought you to this video because of the fact that you're looking at something that might be able to get you some money. But I've also done quite a lot of videos on this channel, so feel free to check one of the others out. But for now, we're just going to jump back into the list. However, the third positive that I've got might sound like one that doesn't apply to you, but then eventually it might. And it's that you might buy a book because you're eventually planning on flipping it, but then halfway along the line, you might hear more about that book and realize that you actually want it for yourself. I'm not going to lie, this happened to me, because I remember that I got given the Iron Man by Kurt Busiek Omnibus when it came out back in 2013. A friend bought it for me as a gift, but it didn't really seem like anything that was up my street, and they weren't even really sure if they brought me the right book. Because as you know, Iron Man by Matt Fraction is the one that's my favorite. But then eventually I ended up reading up more about this run, and I realized that I wanted the book for myself. So originally I was planning on selling it when it did get to a point where it was going to make the best profit for me. But then I realized it was a story that I enjoyed, so it ended up being part of my collection, and I didn't have to pay the overinflated prices that it sits at because of the fact that it's now out of print. And I think this just ties back into the point that even before you need to consider if this is something that you want to do, you have to enjoy this hobby as a fan first. Because it might be the case that you end up getting stuck with an omnibus that you can't really sell, and in that case, it's always best to like the thing that you were trying to sell in the first place. The fourth negative on this list is shipping omnibuses. A lot of people don't consider this at first, and I get people asking me, is it worth getting this book so that you can eventually flip it? And it's something like the Final Crisis Omnibus. Depending on your country, you might live somewhere where there isn't a massive fan base for books like that, and you might have to ship it internationally. And if we're being honest, we live in an age where people are willing to spend £100 on a book, but if the postage is £2, they no longer want it. And comic collectors like stuff in the best condition possible, so are you able to ship that in a way that ensures that there's going to be absolutely no damage? The fourth positive is probably the best way that I think you can capitalize on this opportunity, and that's by being savvy about it, knowing the market, and then going in comic shops directly and seeing what they've got. Now yes, more often than not, they are going to charge cover price, but they might have a book that's a complete whale that nobody might have seen for a good number of years, and you might then be able to flip it immediately on something like eBay. Like I said again, this isn't a practice that I condone, but it is something that I've got the knowledge of, and obviously if people are going to ask me, and if people are watching it to this point, they have to be in a position where they're at least considering it. If you're somebody that hates this practice, why are you watching this video this far in? Because I know that this practice is dodgy, and that there's people that might want that book for a genuine price that now can't get it, and might even have to pay even more because of the fact that somebody's scalping it. But the honest truth that you can't avoid whether you like this or not is that people already do this. But yes, going to a comic shop directly and seeing what books that they've got, and seeing if they've got anything out of print or maybe something that's on offer, is the best way to win at this technique. Because it does minimize a lot of the other risks, because you already know the book's out of print, you could probably already check how much it's been going for in the past, you won't need to sit on it for too long, you can pretty much maybe even get rid of it that weekend. And if you want to help your conscience a little bit, you are helping a comic shop which are in a dying state at the moment. Over lockdown, I've been trying to work as a middleman for UK comic shops, where I'll ask them to look at the shelves, and then I see if anybody wants a certain book, and then I will help guide them to that comic shop so that they can find the book that they wanted, and then see if they do a mail order system. Hopefully those people aren't scalping, because I genuinely just like helping comic fans find the books that they want. But at the same time, it'd be stupid of me to deny that there isn't an opportunity there if it is that you're looking at this for an investment. Number 5 on the negatives that you need to consider is that collector attitude has changed recently. I even joke about this in my series Whale Watch, which I'd recommend checking out because we've got something called the Omar effect, which is whereby Omar at near mint condition, every time he announces a reprint or maybe a new edition of a book, we just watch on eBay as the prices of that original printing just plummet. And it's because of the fact that we've got that knowledge that reprints are going to come out more often, it's not really worth paying overcover price for a book that might get a reprint a year or so down the line. And a lot of collectors are realizing that they don't actually read the books as soon as they come in, so what's the point paying stupid amounts for an out of print book that they're probably not even going to read until a point past where the reprint might have already come out? So many collectors, myself included, have the rule that we won't ever pay overcover price. So your pool of people that are willing to buy your overpriced omnibus that you've scalped on are getting smaller and smaller by the year. Obviously, there's still going to be a couple, and admittedly, if you've only got one copy of a book, you only need one person to pay for it at the price that you're selling it for to actually turn that profit. But with omnibus collecting being more established now than it was even a couple of years ago, it is the case that you might not see as many people wanting to buy that book that you're selling. And scalping isn't a practice that's appreciated or accepted in this community. I'm probably going to get this video the fuck disliked out of because of the fact that I'm just talking about this. The last positive on this list is probably the most obvious one, but it's the fact that there is quite a lot of potential for good returns. This sounds dumb, but when you think about it, if you sell a book for 3 times the cover price, you've made 300% profit on that book. Even though the overall amount of money that you get would be greater, I don't know any house that you can sell for 300% its price, or any kind of gold that you can buy that's going to go up 300%. So if you're somebody who is savvy with this market and you know exactly when you should be buying and exactly when you should be selling, there is the great possibility that you can make a good amount of money with just one book. Like, say for example, say it was 2013 and the Colossal Conan was just coming out. If you bought 5 of them now, you would probably be able to get about 5 grand in total. And that profit is so good that if you did have 5 Colossal Conans, you could probably give me one and you'd still be making a profit. So although there are quite a number of risks, and I think that the main heyday if you were going to try and buy a book as an investment is kind of behind us, I'd be lying if I didn't say that there is still opportunity within it, and a very good opportunity if you're one of the few people that knows the exact way that you should go about this. However, the final negative that I have to end this video on, because I think it's the most important, but also the one that I feel like people won't consider, is that this is mostly a guessing game. Sure, that's the case for any investment, and you've got a little bit of an advantage if you know omnibuses and you've been in this hobby for quite a number of years already. But the fact of the matter is that nothing's certain, and you can see it in the behavior of sellers at the fact that, you know, there'll be so many omnibuses that are out of print for ages, you don't even see any on eBay. A reprint gets announced, and then all of a sudden there's about 40 of them. Those people were just sitting on those books and hoping that one day they'd find the exact right point when they'd sell it. But for me, unless you're absolutely certain that you know you can go about the right way of doing this, I'd recommend against it because of the fact that that money can go towards buying you a book that you actually want. Even though I spend thousands on this hobby a year, I don't consider it something that's very profitable as a fan. And the true joy from this hobby comes from reading those books, enjoying them, and then being able to talk about them with other people. So if you're the person who's either buying them because you want to eventually sell them, it's going to be the case that you're not really reading them, so you're not enjoying them, and also you are keeping that book out of the hands of a fan who might want to be part of that conversation. And I touched on it just before and I want to touch on it again, but hobbies also have their saturation point where it becomes the case that you aren't really going to see as much profit as there used to be. If we're talking about omnibuses, I think it really hit its peak about 3 years ago, because that was the case where you probably had the most amount of omnibus fans, but before we got this wave of reprints coming in. And if we're honest, a lot of people come into a hobby as a get rich quick scheme, so you see all the time with cryptocurrencies, there's always some new cryptocurrency coming out that people think is going to be the new Bitcoin. But then all that happens is it sees a little bit of a boom and then it completely dips off and then another one just comes in. And I think it's the exact same with collecting key issues, because about 10 or so years ago, people were collecting them because they wanted those issues. They wanted the first appearance of Galactus. They wanted a giant size X-Men number one. They wanted the first appearance of Deadpool, but just because of the fact that those were the characters that they like. Now it seems that people only buy and are interested in key issues because of the value that they can eventually have. But then the problem is you're buying it off people that only brought it so that they can turn that profit, and you're only selling it to people that eventually want to make a bigger profit. So the hobby is pretty much entirely consisted of people that are only doing it to make a profit, and not because they actually enjoy the hobby. So that's why I don't recommend people buying any omnibus specifically with the intention of buying it to flip it for a higher price. And also think it just diminishes the point of what the hobby was in the first place. I get ripped on all the time for keeping my books in plastic, but I've got my reasoning behind that, because I often keep moving them about and I don't want to accidentally like rip the dust jacket or anything like that. But at the end of the day, the books that are in my collection are there because I want to enjoy them at some point. I've got a vested invested interest in at least every title that's on the shelf, and eventually I want to get around to reading it. I don't want to look at them just for the purpose of going, the current value of that one's £100, the current value of that one's 80, the current value of that one's 150, because to me, and from the people that I speak to, the people who often watch these videos, that's not what this hobby's about. But I'm going to leave this video there. Hopefully it's helped some of you, especially if you think that you're going to be able to retire at the age of 30 just because you brought a few books off in stock trades. But it is an interesting discussion topic, and on whatever side of this fence that you sit on, I'd like to be able to have a civil, mature, adult conversation in the comments below. Yes, I realise that's probably wishful thinking. As always, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you didn't like this video, why did you get this far? Get your paws all over that subscribe button if you're new here, and hit the bell notification so that you never miss a video. Check out some of my social media links down below and our Reddit page, and I've also got Amazon affiliate links if you're looking to buy anything, because it does really help the channel. But make sure you check out some of my other videos, and until next time, just make sure that you stay safe, stay reading the best books that you can find, and stay mad, all you dogs. Woof woof! See you in the next video.